scenes. They probably were yelling at each other and furious, absolutely furious.
I can just imagine what happened. Bill laid the log out and said, okay, that's it.
His mother, dead on the garage floor. Kip Kinkle played a favorite CD. Hitting the continuous repeat button on a CD player, it would play an anthem of sorts. The soundtrack from that movie he had watched in English class, Romeo and Juliet. Now Kip prepared for what he surely believed would be the last act in his own tragedy.
As I ran across the courtyard, one of our young men screamed at me, "Miss Kinkle." And then immediately ran through the cafeteria and jumped over a couple of kids. And the first thing that hit me was I could smell blood. And looked, and quiet, but saw a lot of kids down, a lot of wounds. Blood spurting out of legs, and all sorts of things. I felt fear. Because I didn't realize that Kip was being tackled off the well.
Kip's rifle was out of ammunition. He pulled the Glock from his belt. Just as he was rushed by a group of students, Kip got off and was shot. They beat him into submission as he screamed, "Just kill me." Hustled Kip out of the cafeteria. In custody, he pulled the knife taped to his leg and attacked a police officer, shouting, "Just kill me."